Good morning. Teacher, yesterday's class we had seen what is actually a BJT, how it can be biased, and we have totally four different types of biasing circuit, out of which we'll be studying the two different types of biasing. Before going into the biasing circuit, we need to understand actually how the equations or how the base current, how the emitter current, how the collector current is related to each other. So considering the operation of the NPN transistor in the active mode, when I say active mode, it should come into your mind that the emitter base junction is forward bias, base collector junction is reverse bias. So you can see here in the active mode of operation, the N-type material what we take are arsenic, antimony and phosphorus, which are group 5 materials in the periodic table. P-type material is aluminium, boron and gallium, which comes under group 3 materials. So, the N material what you have, N type what you have is an emitter site, which is heavily doped. Similarly, P type holes what you have here in the base region is lightly doped. And we know base is considered to be thin. N type material is again the collector site. So, the IE is the current which is flowing across the emitter. IB is the base current and IC is the collector current. Here you have IB, which is equal to IB1 plus IB2, which are mainly because IB1 is because of the injected holes from the base region to the emitter region. Similarly, IB2 are the recombined electrons which are inside the base region. Now, active mode, as I've said you, it is forward bias, which means you can see the two battery connections which is given. These two external voltage sources, what we have as a battery, are used mainly for the required bias condition in the active operation or active mode condition. So this voltage or this VB causes the P-type base to be at higher potential than the N-type emitter. So N-type emitter is negative, P-type base is positive, so it is forward bias, which makes the potential of the base higher compared to the emitter. Forward biasing the emitter base junction. The collector and base junction what we have here, it is VCB, which causes, so positive is to the collector side, negative is to the base side, which causes the N-type collector to be at higher potential than the P-type, thus making the reverse biasing or thus reverse biasing your collector base junction. So this is how is the arrangement of your active mode in terms of NPN transistor. So as I said you, active mode is important. The two external voltages are shown, which are like batteries, to mainly provide the bias condition. So VB causes the P-type base to be at higher potential than the N-type emitter, thus forward biasing the emitter base junction. And the collector base voltage VCB, which causes the N-type collector to be at higher potential than the P-type base, thus causing the reverse bias of the collector base junction. So we just consider only the positive side, that is only the forward bias section. So you can see here this is the base where we provide the VBE voltage positive with respect to the emitter. So between the base and the emitter, we have now PNN, which is nothing but a PN junction, thus acting like a diode. So across this junction in the active mode, the DC operating voltage is 0.7 volt, which is again just like a diode. So when the large current begins to flow, a large number of electrons which are there in N are from the emitter region enter into the base region. So this is P type hole. So this is N. So they are attracted. So there is a, or they enter into the P region. Consider the next condition of the base emitter terminal, that is between the collector and the base PN junction. So base is with respect to collector, it is reverse bias. So in between the collector and the base, there is also a PN junction which is existing. So in this active mode, this junction is reverse bias, or we say it is zero bias. So VCB voltage what we take is zero. So since base region, as I said you, it is lightly doped and it is thin, the carriers from the emitter region are swept into the collector region. So this is how it happens in the reverse bias condition. So the base and emitter terminal between or between the collector and the emitter terminal, there is a large number of current flowing, so which is mainly controlled by this base emitter voltage. So the current flow, if we consider, as I told you, forward bias on emitter base junction. So since you have that forward bias in this junction, emitter base junction, there is a flow of current. So this current, again, it has two components. Electrons will be injected from emitter to base. Holes are injected again from base to emitter. So it will be shown that, again, here, whatever that is happening here, that is holes injecting to the electrons or n-type or electrons injected from emitter to base, both are desirable. So this is mainly achieved because this here electrons are more in number, which means the emitter is heavily doped whereas the base is lightly doped. So because of this, the whole process what I told you is achieved. And emitter current, what we have, that is IE current, is a current which flows across the emitter base junction. The IE, what you have here, you can see it is flowing out of this emitter lead. So whatever the emitter current or whatever you are applying the voltage across this, so the current flows across the emitter base junction is constituting the emitter current, that is IE, and the direction of the IE is out of the emitter lead, which is flowing as per, or which is in the direction of positive charge flow, that is hole current, opposite to the direction of the negative charge flow, that is electron current, such that with emitter current IE will be equal to these two components. The components are nothing but in the direction of positive charge flow, there is hole current. Opposite to the direction of the negative charge, there is electron current. So it will be, or emitter current will be equal of these two components. Next, we have is minority charge carriers. This minority charge carriers is mainly due to when we consider the electrons injected from emitter to base, these electrons will be here now minority charge carriers in the p-type base region. Because the base, you know, it is thin compared to the other, either emitter or a collector. So because the base is usually thin, the excess minority carrier, what you have is electron, the concentration in the base will have almost less. So electron concentration usually will be high at the emitter side and lowest at the collector side. So forward biasing the p-n junction. So these electrons which are inducted from emitter to base, so one will be from emitter to base region, one more will be from base to emitter region. So because I said you, the base is thin, the concentration of this excess minority charge carriers within, it will exhibit a constant gradient. Now here, the emitter region is heavily doped and have high density of electrons, but base is thin, lightly doped, has low density of electrons. So the current flow, that is IE current, between the forward bias emitter base junction, as we know, it is mainly due to the electrons. Sorry, this electronics is there. Electrons flowing from emitter to base. So this process emits free electrons into the base. So among the emitted electrons in the base, around 5% will recombine with available holes in the base region and escapes into external base lead as IB2. That is, if I have to show with respect to this figure, you have seen there in terms of both current, I mean both base currents which are represented. So that is this one. So here, when we have the emitter current flowing, so IB1 is the injected hole, whereas IB2 is nothing but the holes and the electrons what are recombined here. So the recombined holes and electrons what we have here is nothing but the IB2 current. IB1 is the one which is going to get attracted towards the n-type material, and that will make the IB2. IB is equal to IB1 plus IB2. So IB1 is mainly due to majority holes. So remaining 95% base electrons. So 5% is getting recombined. 95% base electrons will act as minority charge carriers and are swept away by to the collector region by electric field, reverse bias what you are giving here. So you can see here, this is the reverse bias condition, DCB voltage. So whatever the remaining 95% base electron, which acts as a minority carrier, which are set to slip away to the collector region by the electric field which is applied to the reverse bias or to the collector base junction. So these electrons are then collected by more positive collector terminal that will make the collector current, or that will constitute the collector current. Thus, we can say that IE is equal to IB plus your IC current, or emitter current is equal to base current plus your collector current. Now, you need to understand only the few equations which are mainly required to solve the problem. So, collector current we have seen based on the operational pins. Usually, we write diode-like equation for a current flowing in the collector current, which is given by IC is equal to IS exponential VBE divided by VT. Here, IS is nothing but the current scale factor, or what we call it as the saturation current. So here, the collector base depletion region what we have, or because the collector current is more positive than base, because it is reverse bias DCB, then what happens, the electrons will be swept across this collector base depletion region into the collector. So the collected, or the electrons will be collected to constitute the collector current, that is IC. We usually say this collector current is equal to IN, so which is actually which will give you the negative value of IC, indicating that IC is flowing in the negative direction. So whenever we express this IC, it is IS into exponential of VBE divided by VT. So IS is a saturation current, which is mainly proportional to area of base emitter junction, inversely proportional to the base region width, inversely proportional to the doping level, and in between 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 18 amps, which is usually the value of IS in the ICs. So it is mainly strongly dependent on the temperature. We have an equation for IS as AEQDNNP0 divided by W, which is not required. Coming to the next current, that is your base current. So this base current is composed of two components. The first component, which is, I have told you, IB is equal to IB1 plus IB2. So the first component which we have is IB1 is due to the holes injected from the base region into the emitter region. And this component, or this current component, is mainly proportional to this equation, or this value, that is VBE by VT. So this IB1 is mainly proportional to VBE by VT. And the second component of the base current, what is nothing but IB2, is due to the holes that have to be supplied by the external circuit so that it can replace the holes lost from the base through the recombination process. So that is electron recombination in the base. So this IB2 is proportional to the electrons injected into the base, and it is also proportional to the previous how IB1 was proportional. Similarly, IB2 is also proportional to VBE, e to the power VBE by VT. So the total base current IB is equal to IB1 plus IB2, which is also proportional to exponential of VBE by VT. So IB can be expressed in terms of fraction of collector current as IC divided by beta. So the base current also has diode-like expression for current, but it's a fraction of collector current. It is called as, the beta is called as common emitter current gain, or beta, and the collector current, which is IB is equal to, or what we, that is base current is equal to IC divided by beta, or you can also represent it as, we know it is also equal to collector current, we have an expression IS exponential VB by VT. If we substitute it here, it will be IS by beta into exponential of e to the power VBE by VT. The next one we have is transistor beta. So the transistor beta is always considered to be a fixed constant in all the electronic circuit components. So in usually dependent, it is dependent on IC, VCB, temperature and operating frequency. The value of beta is always in between 100 to 200, or in NPN transistor, beta is in the range of 50 to 200. It can also be high as around 1000. For this parameter is nothing but the common emitter current gain. So for variations in beta, for considering high values of IC, the recombination increases, which means again beta will decrease because it is IC by beta. And for elevated temperatures, the number of free holes in base region increases, which means beta again decreases with respect to temperature, because both the IC as well as IB will vary with respect to temperature. As VCB increases, effective bandwidth, that is W, decreases, which again decreases your beta value. So beta will be mainly depending on these three factors. Next is emitter current. Since we know the current that enters the transistor must leave, so you can see that in the figure we have seen emitter current IE is equal to sum of collector current and the base current, so which is given by this equation, IE is equal to IC plus IB. So in terms of collector current and common base current gain, so common, which you have seen, the other one, that is beta, is called as common emitter gain. There is one more factor called as alpha, which is common base current gain. So which is IC is equal to alpha into IE. So alpha and beta relationship is given by an equation. Alpha is equal to beta divided by beta plus 1, which is almost equal to 1. So this constant alpha is related to beta with this equation. So which where IE is equal to IC plus IB. So IC plus IB is given by an equation. We know IC by beta. In the previous collector current, we have seen this. So you can take out IC common, multiply the beta. So it will be beta plus IC divided by beta. So if you take IC common, it will be beta plus 1 divided by beta into IC. So in terms of IB, if you have to write the equation, it will be IE is equal to IC plus IB. IC, we know it is beta into IB plus IB, it is beta plus 1 into IB. So IE can be represented in terms of IB as beta plus 1 IB, whereas IE in terms of IC as beta plus 1 by beta into IC. So these are the two important equations of the emitter current. Now we'll just wind up the general biasing process of this active mode. You know, active mode, it is forward bias for base emitter, reverse bias for collector and base. So the transistor arrangement is like this. So VB, we know it is around 0.7 volt, which will forward bias your base emitter junction. BC junction, that is base collector junction, is kept from forward bias condition. So in the usually we say this collector to base voltage is almost zero, whereas cutting voltage, which we have taken as 0.7 or 0.5 volts. So this is usually zero. So we see what we have, that is collector voltage is greater or equal to your base voltage, which is also is greater than your emitter voltage, where VBE we consider is around 0.7 volt. Coming to IC versus VBE for constant VCE. So this is actually the variation, how actually the collector current, for considering the constant VCE voltage, how your IC as well as that is collector current and the VBE voltage follows the diode IV curve. So this is actually similar to your diode. So you have here the collector current, this is your VCE voltage, and at one particular point you will have increase in the current. So this particular value is nothing but your VBE voltage in the transistor active mode. So collector current is given by an expression. This collector current is the saturation current, the exponential variation in the voltage, that is VBE by VT. Similarly, we can see this is actually the ideal response of IC versus VBE VCE curve. So you can see the VBE 3 is greater than VBE 1 or greater than VBE 2. Sorry, VBE 1. So with respect to the output characteristics, that is VCE versus IC, so there is a constant current flowing across the circuit with increasing VBE voltage. So VBE 3 is greater than VBE 2 is greater than VBE 1. So when you give the positive, this is only now the previous what we have seen, it is for the input characteristic. Whereas here, which you see, it is for output characteristic. You can see the collector current, there is a DC voltage. Next is the real. This is actually the ideal. In the practical cases, how we get it, we'll have a sudden increase, a little increase in the DC voltage or IC current, then it will be constant. So here also VBE3 is greater than VBE1, VBE2 and VBE1. So usually when we do the experiments related to the BJT in the practical lab or in the lab, we get the response or the output characteristics of the BJT. So in this way, so only the dependence is on VCE here. So this is IC versus VCE for a constant VBE voltage. So for a constant VBE, a small VCE voltage, that is which will make the BJT into the saturation region. So this is actually the which will show you the regions of the operations of the BJT. So you can see here this particular region what we have, that is VBE at a 0.7. This is the saturation region. We know it is active, saturation and cutoff. So linear dependence on IC versus VBE for constant VBE defined for an early effect. So this is actually for your active mode, which is the early, which we call it as an early effect. So if both these conditions are reversed, then we get here is a cutoff region. So this modeling, which is called as the BJT, which is modeled as an early effect, is actually the extrapolated curve which we say at this point we have seen in the VCE output characteristics. If I want to show you the graph, so this exponential what we have. So this is because of the equation what you have there, exponential is mainly because of this. So this is actually the point what we call it as VA comma 0 or minus VA comma 0. So VA is the early voltage what we get, and the voltage value is around 50 to 100 volt. So IC is given as IS into exponential VBA by VT, 1 plus VC by VA is for this equation. Again, I'll tell you, you need to understand only the concept. This particular concept is not there in the syllabus. You have only the biasing concept. But knowing those equations is important for the problematic, to solve the problem. Now, there is one more which we have to define as the output resistance. Now, we know this is actually with respect to VC and IC, how the constant VBE is obtained. For a non-zero slope of IC versus VCE, we actually measure the output resistance looking into the collector part of the BJT. So, which is output resistance is given as R0 as BJT output resistance. So, it is given by an equation dou IC, that is the collector current. We know resistance is nothing but I by V, or it is collector current to the VCE voltage, keeping the VBE as constant. So with respect to this, or with respect to the change in the output resistance, the small variation, so it is actually V by I, so we are taking it inverse. So this is VA by IC, because the voltage what we have here, we are considering it as VA for R0, and the collector current is changing with respect to this, so it is IC. So R0 is equal to VA by IC is the equation. So the summary of this NPN active mode characteristics which we have seen is, one is the IC equation with respect to the voltage, IB equation, R0 equation, IC with respect to this emitter, alpha as well as IE with respect to IB, and what is the emitter current. So this is actually the NPN characteristics in the active mode. Similarly, now we have PNP transistor in active mode. So this is just difference is you have P type material as emitter, N type material as base, again P type material as collector. So IE is again the emitter current, IB is again the base current, this is injected electrons, this is recombined holes, this will be the collector current, IB is again IB1 plus IB2. This is active mode, so this is forward bias emitter base junction. So you can see how the forward bias is, positive is connected to emitter, negative is connected to the base. So since this is N type, so it is, this is P type. So it is forward bias. Here again, This is high compared to your emitter doping and the concentration. Similarly, the base is positive, collector is negative, so it is reverse biased. So the NPN or PNP transistor here you have to note down is in NPN we had BBE, in PNP it is BEB. Similarly, in NPN we had VCB, here it is VBC. So this is how the arrangement of the PNP transistor is done. Here, out of the emitter lead, the current flowing was reverse in case of PNP. Here it is towards the emitter current. Similarly, here it is out of the collector current. So the arrangement what we have, so you can see here this is actually NPN. Out of the emitter lead, we used to have the emitter current. So the arrangement is towards from the collector to the emitter. Whereas here, it is into the emitter. So the configuration when we see, it is into the emitter to the collector. So PNP operational mode is similar to that of your NPN operational mode. Cutoff means base emitter junction is reverse, base collector junction is reverse. Active is forward of base emitter, again base collector is reverse. Saturation base emitter is forward, base collector is forward. Reverse active is base emitter is reverse and base collector is forward. So in considering your PNP, see here that I have said you into the emitter. So you can see the arrow mark, it is into the emitter then to the collector. So this is actually the arrangement of the active mode. So this is emitter base is forward bias, collector base is reverse bias. So VEB voltage in case of PNP is also 0.7 across the emitter base junction. Collector base junction is kept from the forward bias condition. So this is actually considered to be zero. So VE should be greater or equal to VB, should be greater than VC. So VEB voltage will be 0.7 volt. So again, the same equations will apply for your PNP active mode characteristics, that is your IC voltage, IB voltage, R0 as the output resistance, collector current, alpha value. So all the equations will remain similar. So this is the arrangement of your PNP transistor. So again, this we have seen yesterday how the family of the curves is defined, which is IC value, both cases. This is IB, VB, instead of VB, it is VEB. To the VCE voltage, we have active region, saturation region, and cutoff region. So as I have told you, active region mainly for analog applications, and the saturation or cutoff will be mainly for the digital applications. So in general, we can see here the collector current IC is given by this equation with respect to the variation, that is exponential VB by VC, base current IC by beta, where IC is having this value substituted here, emitter current is IE is equal to IC plus IB. So for any value, I told you IC usually when we take the collector current, it is equal to IN. So it is N is equal to 1 means the saturation current should always have a range. It should be lesser than 10 to the power minus 12, greater than 10 to the power minus 14 amps. Thermal voltage, that is VT, which we have is 25 milliamps, sorry, millivolt. So the collector current is mainly independent of your VCEB and for VCB greater or equal to 0. So collector current will behave as an ideal constant current source where the current is determined by your VBE. So IC, we have seen it is alpha is equal to IA. This is just a summary. IC is equal to beta IB. Alpha is beta by beta plus 1. So we know that beta is common emitter gain constant and alpha is the common base current gain. Emitter current, it is given by this equation. So there is a exercise for you to do. So you have to find out for an NPN transistor having IS is equal to 10 to the power minus 11 amps, beta is 100, VT is equal to 25 millivolts. So you have to calculate what is the VBE voltage for IC, which is 1.5 amps. And the answer is also given. You need to do it and submit it in the Google Classroom. The question will also be put in the Google Classroom. And at last, the summary comparing this active mode and saturation mode. So collector current, emitter current, collector current in terms of IB, collector current in terms of IE, what is the total equation of emitter current, what is the equation of alpha and beta with respect to each other, and for PNP, I've said you, VBE is replaced with VEB, So saturation mode is nothing but both the conditions, both the resistor junctions will be forward bias. So there will be a correct collector current flowing. IC will not be equal to beta IB because the value what we get here, the collector current will be less than the beta IB. IA will remain same. DC voltage will be less, that is almost equal to 0.2 volt. And how actually the current is dependent, I told you this particular, whatever they say, take the collector current or the base current. So everything will be dependent on the current, voltage, temperature, and we have seen what is the modeling of the early effect. Early effect is this one what we have. So with respect to the NPN transistor, so all the equations you have seen here, so the same R0 equation is given. And here also you have an exercise to solve. So if the BJT has VA is equal to 100 volts, IC is equal to 1 milliamp, you need to calculate what is, so it's a direct application, you need to calculate what is R0. Again, this question will also be put in the Google Classroom. For the next class, we'll be seeing what I've told you, that is biasing circuit. The first biasing circuit we'll be looking into is classical discrete circuit bias arrangement, or it is called as voltage divider bias. Next, we'll be looking into biasing using a collector to base feedback resistor. So these two biasing circuits. So we'll continue in the next class. Thank you.